Blackstone Audiobooks presents The Pirate Coast by Richard Zacks. To Mr. Robert Berman, Mentor and Tormentor. Prologue. An hour before dawn on September 3, 1798, the waves of the Mediterranean tugged at the coast of the island of San Pietro near Sardinia, lullabying the thousand or so sleeping residents. So peaceful was it, so rhythmic and hypnotic the sound, or perhaps it was due to a bottle of local vino bianco that even the two municipal watchmen in the church tower had fallen asleep. So there was no one to puzzle out the faint white flecks of sail growing larger on the pinkish-gray horizon, and no one to ring the massive church bells to sound the alarm that a fleet of 7 ships was approaching. Standing silently at the rail of these lateen-sailed ships, visible in faint silhouette, were bearded men in loose billowy pants and turbans, carrying scimitars and pistols. The vessels, packed with 1,000 Barbary pirates from Tunis in North Africa, glided to anchor inside the harbor. The crews quietly lowered small landing boats and began to ferry men ashore. The first group, barefoot and heavily armed, raced to seal off the 2 roads leading out of town. Surprisingly, the leader of this attacking Moslem fleet, the pirate commodore, as it were, was an Italian who had converted to Islam. The ritual had involved losing his foreskin and gaining a new name. He was now Muhammad Rumeli, and in the lingua franca slang of the Mediterranean, he was dubbed a rinnegato, a renegade. Over the centuries, the rulers of the Barbary countries of Algiers, Tunis, and Tripoli had learned that Christian captains could navigate better than their homegrown Muslim talent. Another Italian, acting as harbor pilot, had guided the fleet to the perfect anchorage. This fellow from Capri, never identified by name, carried a deeply personal motive for joining the attack. He had married a woman from San Pietro, but she had abandoned him. He was now convinced that she was cuckolding him here on the island. He had turned Turk expressly to seek his revenge. As the first ray of dawn caught the sails, Muhammad Rumeli gave the signal to wake up the townspeople. The pirates unleashed a sudden, unholy thunder. The ship's cannons bellowed out broadsides. The sailors on shore added a lunatic's drum roll of small arms fire. The cacophony climaxed as close to 1,000 mouths let loose impassioned Arabic war cries, and the men rushed into the town. Allahu Akbar speeded their pursuit of profit. The corsairs engulfed the tiny town. They battered down the doors, burst into homes, brandishing torches and scimitars, rousting the stunned citizens from bed and kicking them into the streets. They cursed their victims as Romo Kelb, Christian dogs. The women cowered in corners, trying to avoid what one observer described as shame and villainies. A French naval officer, arriving the next day, found that 5 women had died in their beds of knife wounds, their bodies entwined in sheets caked with blood. The first female victim, according to local accounts, was the unfaithful wife of that pilot from Capri. A Sardinian historian later called her a fishwife Helen, who had no idea that her husband's jealous rage had drawn the enemy to her homeland. The attackers spent the entire day hauling money, jewels, church silver, silks to the harbor. But by far the most valuable commodity to be stolen walked on 2 legs, human slaves. Surah 47 of the Quran allowed these Muslim attackers to enslave and ransom any of these captives. Young Italian women would fetch more than the men in the flesh markets of Tunis and Algiers. The crews dragged the townspeople aboard various ships, tossing them like ballast willy-nilly below deck into the holds for the 160-mile voyage. The prisoners wore only what they had slipped into at bedtime on that seemingly unimportant September night, which would turn out to be their last night of freedom for half a decade. This was life on a Mediterranean island circa 1798, in the age of Napoleon and Nelson, and the waning days of the Barbary corsairs. The Bey of Tunis, the country's ruler, had commissioned these 7 ships and 1,000 men to attack San Pietro. To the Bey they were his privateers, fighting a legitimate war against Sardinia, which had refused to pay tribute to him for the right to navigate the Mediterranean. To the rest of the world, these 7 ships were Barbary pirates, part of a centuries-old extortion scheme. Fall weather on the Mediterranean can run skittish, and storm winds kicked up. The San Pietro prisoners spent the next 4 days seesawing in the windowless, foul-smelling dark, appalled at their fate, vomiting, weeping, with no sanitation, and almost no food or water. That is, all except 6 young women, 6 jeunes filles, ran a later report in French from a Dutch consul, Antoine Nissen, in Tunis. 6 young girls, alas that they were still so, were selected by the Reis, captains, to serve their filthy desires.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.